everyone, let's start with the second part of the chapter, active and passive voice. I had already given the rules of the active and passive voice. I hope you all have learned. Now let's start the active and passive voice. Before we start the active and passive voice, I would like to ask you, what is sentence? Yes, sentence is a group of words which gives complete sense. And what is the structure of the sentence? The sentence structures are, first comes subject, then verb, then object. What is subject? Subject, one who is doing the action or about which something is said. And what is object? The object of a sentence is the person or thing that receives the action of the verb.
Let's see through this example. Here, the fruit fell on the lion. The fruit is subject here. Why? Because fruit is doing the action or something. We are talking about the fruit here. And fail is verb. You know what is verb? All the doing words or action words are known as a verb. On the lion is a object here because action is happening or lion is receiving the action. So lion is object. I hope you understood what is sentence. Let's begin with the active and passive voice. What is voice? Voice is the form of the verb which indicates whether the subject is the doer of the action or something is being done to it. Voice has two parts. One is active and another is passive. In the active voice, the subject of the sentence does the action, and in the passive voice, the subject of the sentence receives the action. Before begin, you must know some rules. In active voice, sentence structure will be subject plus verb plus object. But in passive voice, it will be changed into object plus verb plus subject. It means subject in the active voice will become the object in the passive voice, and object in the active voice will become the subject in the passive voice. In passive voice, we use V3 form and use by after V3, and we never change the tense. Even passive pronoun rules, I change into me, we change into us, he change into him, she change into her, they change into them. You and it remain unchanged in the passive form. Look at these sentences. The teacher teaches the student. Here the teacher is subject, teaches verb, and the student is object. Here we will change into passive voice. Then subject will become object and object will become subject. We will change into passive. Then it will become the student is taught by the teacher. Here student became subject and teacher became object because we have changed subject into object and object into subject, and we put the V3 form, teaches V3 form. In all the tense we use V3 form and we put the preposition after the V3. Let's see one more example. Peter writes a story. Here what is Peter? Peter is a subject, writes is a verb, and a story is a object. Now change into passive. A story is written by Peter. Writes, V3 form will be write, wrote, written. I hope you all know the verb form. So here object, a story became the subject. Here a story is written by Peter, and Peter is a subject in the active, became the object in the passive. And we put the why preposition after the V3 form. In all these sentences, same messages are given in two different ways. That is, first in the active and then in the passive voice, without changing the meaning or the tense. Hope up to here you have understood the chapter. Now you revise once more. Thank you.